weeks are over. It's all about football all the time as we're underway here in week 13. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Ezekiel Elliott, last year's NFL rushing leader. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. For Zeke, what a first 3 years he's had in the NFL. Last year, his second rushing title, 1,434 yards. Not as many as 1,631 that he had as a rookie, but still his yards per game average was the best in the National Football League. Here's second and 7 now from the 28.
You can't block me.
Here's Prescott. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll run with Elliott. And he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. A nice job to get 8 there after the incompletion, and now they'll look at a 3rd and 2 coming up. Way forward, but it looks like he did not make it. He needed 2, he got 1, and that's going to leave him with 4th down and a yard. So on 4th down, here's Chris Jones to punt it away. He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. Taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up.
Get up! 180! Mike,
On third down, Trubisky, and able to find Graham, complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards that time, and a Buffalo first.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
Yeah, that was a good start getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. He's got the first down and more past midfield. And finally brought down at the 43. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards. That's his longest run of the first quarter. And, Charles, we talked before the game about them needing to establish the run game. They'll be looking for more of that.
And they got to the perimeter. So that tells me that that's part of the game plan of what they want to get done today. So they'll have some complimentary runs where he'll run it to the inside. But it appears that when they want the big yardage, they think they can get to the outside and make it happen.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, he couldn't turn it into much more.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 28.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Trubisky to throw again. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if they're going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, the quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
Let's see what they draw up here. Third and long following the sack of Trubisky. From the shotgun is Trubisky. And unable to connect, incomplete. Give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the seven they wanted, but they'll take the three.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard. But it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the three.
Yeah, they had three first downs and 3 points. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And to be frank, they're just in a tough spot. It's only November, already eliminated from playoff contention. I know their fan base doesn't want to hear that, but that's the case. What are they fighting for now going forward?
You know exactly what they're fighting for. It's that word that some people don't want to hear, but it's pride.
Draft. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I was going to go draft, but pride's better, right?
You know something? You're right, because that's part of it, but that's two different mindsets. That's front office mindset, draft position. Where are we going to be and what do we need to get? And then the players and the coaching staff right now. Can they win some games and feel better about themselves despite the fact they have no shot at the playoffs?
It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
It's now third and five.
Here I come. Here I come.
Here we go, 47.
Here's Prescott. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete. Certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down. Out now comes the Cowboys punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. They'll run on first down. It's Moss, and he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
One thing rookies need to learn at this level and quick, make a cut, be decisive, and go. Because in college, you could dance around and wait for a hole to open because you're probably a better athlete.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. DeMarcus Lawrence racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. Well, there was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Let's see what they draw up here. Third and long following the sack of Trubisky. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And able to find John Brown. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. The last run got 6, now second and 4. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Partner, those are back-to-back 6-yard runs, and if they're going to continue to get those types of plays, shoot, you just keep running the same stuff, don't you?
Yeah, it was first and 10, then second and 4. Now first and 10 again. Here's Trubisky. And this one caught by Beasley. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard, your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. Play action. Now Trubisky. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Jalen Smith. What a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player. But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now Trubisky on third and long. And that's caught by Beasley. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. 25 yards that time.
Nice catch right there. Brings to mind the sentence. When in doubt, find your veterans.
You used to laugh back in the day when they would call guys like him crafty veterans. You get up in your 30s. And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Devin Funches. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Bills will add on to their lead. Extra point good by Catanzaro. And the lead grows to 10-0. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 44. Prescott to throw it. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. And that is incomplete. Showed off the arm strength there, but to no avail. Second down.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Here's Elliott. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield.
That's a really good job right there. Just kept stringing that play out, pushing further and further towards the sideline. Really good fundamentals by that defense.
He was trying to put his foot in the ground and turn upfield. He just couldn't.
No, they really had a picket fence in front of him. No room to find to get upfield.
Looking to throw. Prescott. And that is incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get to third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
...46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. It's a 42-yard punt, but 8 on the return. And the Bills will take over the football with a first and 10. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. It doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And it'll be 3rd and 10. It's Trubisky. And he finds Beasley complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Trubisky now 9 of 11 passing in this first half. He's got his guys a 1st and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And a good burst there gets him 7 up to midfield.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
From midfield now, here's Trubisky. This will be caught by Brown. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 30.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped down the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Now a handoff here to his running back. Finding room to the 20. And finally down at the 9-yard line. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit, because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next drive.
That's caught by Brown for a Bills touchdown. John Brown, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bills will add on to their lead. Oh, how about this? No good. Just his second miss of the year. And our score will stay right where it is. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This will be fielded at the 8. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. So far, they've had 3 drives, 3 punts. Not good.
Not good indeed, because you've got to have something to show for being out.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jerry Hughes, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away, because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Hey, Kill. 47.
Hey, come on out here. Come get some. Come on here.
Third and long for Prescott. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. It'll go as a gain of 25 on a play that started back at the 25.
Thus far, it hasn't been a real fun half for them, but a play like that, that may get them off the schneid a little bit, get them loosened up and moving.
Kind of seems like they've been sleepwalking and still sitting on 0 points.
And it's not always making an adjustment. Sometimes it's just going back to what you know.
Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. Cooper was the intended target.
Oh, man, Brandon, not a real good throw that time. It looked like he tried to put a little too much air under this one, and it turned into a floater. And defensively, this is a dream. He could have fair caught that one. That was way too easy.
On first down, Moss. So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. A carry here for the big tight end. And he'll push forward here for a good little run as the clock continues to run. Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be 3rd and 3 now. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
And he's going to have a first down, but not sure it'll matter as the clock will continue to run. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. Bills with the lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Here's second and seven now from the 28. Throwing here, Trubisky. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you can go make a play on the football.
They go play action. Trubisky. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he's got the first down yardage before being taken down at midfield. A good pickup there, a 22.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Moss. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. It'll be a 5-yard pickup there. So from second and 13, they're back to a more manageable third and 8. Now it's Trubisky. Throw there, going to be incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And he finds his target. It's Schultz. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work. And that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Now Prescott connects here with the tight end, Blake Jarwin. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. So first and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 48-yard line. Prescott from the gun. This to Jarwin. 20! And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. The big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards.
They're still looking for their first touchdown of the game, and for a second, I thought they had it right there.
Now looking on the sideline, it's finally good to see nods of approval. It's a welcome sign of life that this offense needed. So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. This is Elliott. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Again, it's Elliott. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year as they are able to cut into that lead. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's good, and that cuts it to 9 at 16-7. So the lead is now dwindled to 9 as the kick here is away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football, because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing, but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13.
Alert, 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 alert.
Here's Trubisky to throw. He hits Beasley right side. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
How about the fellas with the stars on the side of their helmets rising up on defense? We always hear about the Cowboys rushing offense. Their rush defense is pretty good as well, I think, because they're so cohesive. Defensive line, linebackers really work well together.
12 yards on the return that time, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try to cut down the length of the drive.
22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. Looking back to Cooper's numbers from last year after that trade, he ended up playing 9 games with the Cowboys in 2018. 725 yards, 6 scores. Also had the 100-yard game in the playoffs against the Rams. And if you add up the numbers between the two teams last year, he was over 1,000 for the third time in 4 NFL seasons.
It's interesting going into this game, there was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage. I think we've seen who has it in this one so far.
Well, they bottled him up. He's barely averaging over 3 yards a carry right now. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he's got a first down as the tackle made at the Bills' 22-yard line.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense, because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
A first down carry by Elliott. Give him 10 there, good enough for a Cowboy first down.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game.
doesn't.
51 to Mike, boy. 51.
Who there? Who there?
A first down throw for Prescott. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Shane Ray, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
Hindsight is 20-20, partner. Maybe they should have kept it on the ground again.
Well, it almost looked like the O-line was run-blocking again. I mean, they opened up a big hole last time. This time they opened up a hole, and the quarterback got sacked.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Throwing on second and long. Prescott, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dalton Schultz, his first touchdown on the year, as they have now chopped this lead down to 3. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and the lead is down to 2. So the lead shaved to 2 now as the kickoff is away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They've been asleep for a little while on this side of the football, Charles, and the score is just a one-score game now. Points this half, what gives?
Let's go old school here. All right, let's get back to the basics. Get back to running the football, high percentage throws. Find the guys that eat pressure and make plays for you and make sure they touch it.
Both teams working on short rest, but this has been one of the better Thursday night games we've seen as they come up here on 1st and 10. Now it's Trubisky. And Graham's got it, complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Give him 18 on that one as the Bills are going to have a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me. I'm going to keep firing.
A running play on first down, and it turns into a fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10.
What's the run? They're running it.
From the shotgun is Trubisky. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's 3rd down.
And now offensively it's 3rd and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. He needed 9, he got 8. And that's going to leave him with a 4th and 1 on their side of the field. This one is right down the middle, and that will push the lead up to 5. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, it's a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now, because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
He can muster only a yard there, and they'll be left with a third and very short.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in four tries. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Looking for Cooper, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And he returns it into enemy territory, down to the 45-yard line. Intended that time for Cooper.
I tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely, you want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Now, a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. The Bills on third down. They're hitting at 60%, 6 out of 10 thus far. This is third and four. Out of the gun, Trubisky. And that will be incomplete. The Notre Dame man, Jalen Smith, able to get a hand in and knock it away.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
From a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Last year, Dak Prescott had 3 fourth-quarter comebacks, and he's in search of another one right now. They'll run on first down. It's Elliott, and he'll take it across midfield and into Buffalo territory. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. They go to Elliott again. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook. Go play action. Toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down. Keep the sticks moving.
They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Pass on target, Prescott to Cooper. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
Prescott now, 11 of 17 passing thus far. He's got his guys a first and 10. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. He's got the first down inside the 10. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Sometimes those lines that are drawn on a grease board or in a playbook, they come to life out on the field, don't they? And we just saw that on that outside handoff to the right.
That right tackle, he gets excited for that call, doesn't he?
He does, because he just wants to dominate his guy and say, listen, I was the point of attack. I took care of business. That's why you're able to get downfield and add all those yards to your total.
Yeah, really nice gain there. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Ezekiel Elliott. His second touchdown of the afternoon as they now sit just a two-point conversion away from tying this game up in the fourth quarter. All right, so the Cowboys will go for two here. They'll try and run it in, but he is not going to make it. It's a big play by the defense, and they're going to hold on to their two-point lead. So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. This will be taken about the 12. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Two minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter. So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. He'll have a first down past the 40. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 11 yards and a Buffalo first down.
Well, they got the yardage they needed there. Picked up the first down, got out of bounds. How about the urgency that they have as well as the understanding where they are in the field?
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Second and long, but you got to figure this almost certainly another run. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Moss, and he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as he'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Throwing now is Trubisky. And he gets it to Funches complete. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Every penalty so critical at this stage of the game as now they've got it third and long. Now it's Trubisky. And that is incomplete.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
And it's taken in at the 9. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And that will come the offense as they take over. The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that'll be incomplete. Good protection that time, and they couldn't hook up on the long one. Now it's third down. Charles, I think back to your earlier statement about the visitors being the underdogs needing to win that turnover battle, and this defense, they forced 2 turnovers so far, big reason why they lead this game.
Yeah, and I know defenses always talk about getting turnovers in bunches, getting those takeaways. 2's not a bunch, but it's plenty in this game, exactly the formula they need. I got to tell you, partner, I like it when you think back to something I said. It actually comes true. It's actually right.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line.
And that one, oh, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to come up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo first down.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one, despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
And I think this defense knew what was coming, as he is smothered behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd and 11. The Cowboys signal for their 3rd and final timeout as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, 2nd and 11. Going to give this time to the tailback. And able to work his way down to the 16. 7 yards on the carry, make it 3rd and 4 coming up.
You got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a 2nd and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to 3rd and manageable with that run.
And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down. So now Catanzaro comes on in a pressure spot.